Hello everybody, welcome back. This is going to be episode 13 for our Legendary Beastmen campaign for Total War Warhammer. I'm the Strategy Professor. If you're just joining us for the first time, this is a pure campaign, which means that we're not going to abuse the auto-resolve system at all, we're not going to assassinate lords on the campaign map, and we're not going to do any other kind of tomfoolery that might give us an unfair advantage over an opponent. So, let's go ahead and get back in here. And we have series for everything except for chaos so far on this channel. So if you like this video, start at the beginning, watch it all the way through. It's been a great campaign so far, and maybe check out some of the other campaigns too. There's lots of good content out there. Okay, so last time we confederated for the first time, and it's actually really good if you confederate. You get a reduction in upkeep and all sorts of other perks across the board if you confederate. So it's really, really good if you can find other beastmen and confederate with them, which I think is sweet. Like, I like that there's a trade-off with the greenskins and the Empire and all of them, but the Beastmen are already so challenging, and it's just really hard to make friends with anybody, that it's really cool that if you keep your diplomacy up and you just aren't constantly doing dastardly things, if you keep your steadfast rating, then it is still worth it. There is still some diplomacy that could potentially be worth it. Because you can confederate with other Beastmen factions. Okay, well, so we just picked this guy up. Now, I was going to run him over and rejoin him with these guys, but this is actually a very, very exposed place. It only has six people holding down the fort. Now, my guy is really injured, is the only problem. He has 185 health, so that's a problem. But what I'm thinking is, if I just set up camp here and recruit maybe two spearmen, then I think I can take it next turn. So I can hit it from here. Let me go ahead and... move up just a little bit here into these woods. They get a little bit more vision, and it makes it a little bit less likely that they're going to be able to get me, or just detect me. So I'm still... oh, I can't replenish because of the event, so because he's under my auspices now, there's no replenishment for him. That's okay. I think if I just get a couple of spearmen, then I should be able to burn this town. So I think that'll be worth it. Okay, so we get to upgrade here. Just seeing if we got any more things. I know we just got a... let's see what this does. Okay, that's pretty cool. Your campaign line of sight's good. I think poison attacks is very good, too. Okay, we'll leave it there for now. We'll think about it here in a little bit. Oh, sweet. I get the Racer Gore Chariot. I think that's what I want. What does it give me? It gives me, like, a zillion melee attack. Look at that melee attack. A zillion charge bonus. Yeah, this just looks like it's off the charts, really. Or is that down? No, my melee attack's gonna go down a zillion. That's what it's saying. I thought it was going up. So, I don't know about this then. Like, it would give me a lot of speed so that I can be places and just act as a shock troop and hit the back line, but it might hurt me a little bit in terms of just standing and fighting without that charge bonus. I mean, I'm usually a huge fan, but that's just not going to let me sit in combat. I'm just going to have to cycle charges a lot. Which, I mean, to be fair, I should be doing that anyways. It's going to lower my melee defense a lot. Lower my weapon strength, but I'm going to get a massive charge bonus. I'm going to do it, whatever. I think it'll be worth it. I mean, look at that thing. That's sick. Yeah, that's awesome. Oh, man. Take a drink there real quick and just admire the beauty. That's gorgeous. Don't you just want to kiss that thing? Oh. Not that much. Oops. That's okay. We're going to go in that direction anyways. I think we're going to attack them. I mean, double check his stats. Okay, so his melee attack's only 50, but he has a 90 charge bonus now, and he moves at 69 speed. His weapon strength went down a little bit, but he gets a bonus versus infantry of 26. Okay, so that makes up for his melee attack then, so he can sit in combat and still do the same melee attack even if he doesn't have the charge bonus, because he has that bonus versus infantry. As long as I have him attacking infantry, which I will. Weapon strength plus 10%, wow, that's pretty good. Although melee attack plus 8 I think is better, because that's more than 10%. Right, you just don't get a lot of items. Alright, so...
Do you take me for a child?
Now, I don't know if I count as large, though, now that I have this chariot. So I don't know if these spearmen are really going to tear me up. But either way, I think we can beat them. So they have 9, and then Musilin has... Now, they have a lot of... Oh, I was looking at Leonice. Never mind. Yeah, that would be harder, but this I think we should be able to do. 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15 on my 34. That's good. Let me just go ahead and combine some of these. The Bray Herd's already died. Leon Kerr killed the Bray Herd. So it's okay if we pull some of these together. Okay, I think that's pretty solid. This we need to keep 17.
I am a lord of
Bretonnian. Right, so let's go ahead and this guy up over here. Now, if I hire, I can't hire this turn. Who just got the? Maybe I want to attack with the other guy first, because this is the guy I think that can make the magic user, and I want to go ahead and get that going. Yes, this. Wait. It takes more than one turn? I thought it was done in one turn. Does it take 2 turns to build? Okay, anyways, I need to bring him right here so that I can continue building after we do this fight. Yep, let's do it. Then he should still have enough movement speed left to do the fight. Okay. So, pretty close, but I think we should be able to deal with this. These knights are a problem, obviously, but we have so many spearmen. I mean, yeah, they're a little dinged up, but I still think we can tear those knights up with all these spearmen. They don't have a lot of... spearmen of their own, which is the only thing that's really stopping my minotaurs from stomping them. They have a couple, but not many. And the chariot should actually be really good for rounding up these archers. Alright, let's do it. Oh, frenzy. Who wants frenzy? What is this? Missile resistance, melee defense. I mean, I could put frenzy on just the chariot guy. Nothing there. Alright, let's do this. Try out this new chariot. Never thought of having a lord on a chariot, which is an interesting concept. Where are these reinforcements? Okay, so ours are coming in over here. He might just naturally have his. I'm not sure. Alright, so we can... I think we can safely assume that the enemy computer hacks, like they know where you are. Based on what we saw last episode and just what I've seen in the past. I need to make sure I gain control of this hill. can just put him with the normal people, I guess. We'll make him the 10 spot. The king of the hill here. I'm not sure if they're going to come up this hill at me or not. They're kind of moving around over there. I should be able to get them in a downhill position. One way or another. Put him all the way at the end, just so it's easier to keep track of him. All the way at that end. Come on. Well, maybe not. As long as I can see him, it's fine. No, this guy needs to be over here. Alright. Add those to the two group. I'm gonna put guard mode and skirmish on them. He doesn't have any. Oh, he does. So I'll just use that pretty soon. I should put that on my chariot guy after this fight. Fresh. Okay, so we're just waiting on all these guys. I'll just go ahead and speed it up here. Are they coming at me? I think they're just hanging out. They're probably wanting to fight me in those woods, since I have missile superiority. And they're fresh after running all that way, running up hills. I like this. Why are we crawling? Run. There we go. Is kind of in the back for now. Form these up here. Clean shots. These guys around the perimeter. Shots in, get some shots in. Thank you. Oh, you gotta stop by the tree. That's a pretty lame charge. I do say so myself, pretty lame charge. These guys might come over here and try to make a play on my spears. I don't know what they're doing. Here, come get it. Okay, so note to self, chariots are not good at running through woods. Okay, just make sure we kill these guys, it's fine. Oh, my guy took a little bit of damage here. Forgot to pop that, it's okay. This must be knights of the round, or the realm, because they just are not taking damage. Okay, let's get over here and deal with these knights with the minotaurs. We're just not going to be able to catch him. I think we'll run away from that. There's just too much going on over there. I need to get over here with my range units. Because I can kill those stupid horse archers, the bane of my existence. Jeez, there's more of them. Get over here, kill this, kill this, kill this. Alright, so they should be done here. Yeah. They're done. So that was pretty good. It's pretty good. How many? I killed quite a few. I didn't even get a lot of really good charges in there, to be honest. Come on, baby. Run up this hill. He's probably really tired. Yeah, he's just like trot. Get up. Get these guys in. That charge in there. Oh, look at that power! Ah! Just like walking on him. Okay, there he goes. He's got his second win. Oh, we got the Lord too, finally. Yes, yeah, we've got a pretty formidable little force here. Downhill! I just wait and let him catch his breath for a second. Attacked in the flank. Let's get in there and get a good charge in, let's see. I just want to see it. Even very tired, I think we can do some damage. Let's see. Oh, never mind. Well, he's still got quite a few. Dang. Get away. I mean, doing a lot of damage on those things. Let's go over here and charge these guys. Get another good hit in here. I need to get that vigor thing, that vigor skill. Oh, he's not very good uphill. Okay, we got a couple. Speed it up here. Let's chase him off the map. He's still not exhausted yet, though. He's just very tired. So it was those Centaurs, they'd never get tired, which is really sweet, but I just feel like the Minotaurs outshine them a little bit. Maybe I'm wrong. I could try them out at some point. So who killed the most? Oh, it's tough to say here. These Minotaurs obviously did a ton. Even charging into those Halberdiers was fine because we were charging into their back, so they didn't get the anti-charge bonus. Nice. Lots of loot. Chunk of XP. And loot and raise.
Consider making camp, Beast Lord. An encampment will draw more gores to your cause, allowing your
followers. He's just like, your units are really hurt. You might want to consider encamping.
Tribute.
Well, I would love to do that, sir. But I have a debuff right now that says I cannot gain any more health back from encampment. Oh, a Helm of Discord with +2 armor. That's pretty good. It's pretty nice. It's really nice. Noticed by the gods. I guess the gods don't like you if you kill a lot of things, so you do not want to get noticed by the gods, is what this is seeming to say to me. It'd be 15. I really want that chariot on him. It's a lot of fun. True beast. Okay, I need to start. I probably need to start transitioning over to Children of Chaos at this point. So, the attrition might be better than, just as a 1-point wonder, than the rating. So I think I'll go Dark Apothecary. And then Holy Resilience, and then we'll get Children of Chaos. I do want to get Freakish Mutations. There's just so many good things. I mean, Slug Skin is crazy for every single type of unit. 20% extra damage. Obviously superb. I mean, that even applies to Lords. Alright, so now I need to encamp. Okay, they still have 17, so that means I still have this. I don't need this. I could use this to siege Artois. Could be a decent plan just to kind of hold down the fort for a little bit, maybe weaken them. I could also send it over here in anticipation of the Paramount Bastogne army. I mean, heck, I could use this guy to tag team some things with this army. This army starts it, and then this army reinforces it. Might be able to do that. Yeah, let's try it out. I don't think we're gonna need it over here. We've already crushed what I believe is all of their armies. We'll see. If I get something that heals, I might want to do that next instead of the growth. Kazrak. Like the bonus healing. Not sure though. He didn't take this area down here yet. That's good. No one's taken all this. Alright, let's go for... I could move a little bit more. Just to get into a better position to attack next turn. And I still want to make sure I'm within reinforcement range here. Okay, his range is right here, so I should be able to go up a little bit more. It's hard to tell because he's like this unit frame is so huge. Hard to tell exactly what is what's doing what. Yeah, his frame looks a lot larger. Maybe it's the same. Okay, well, let's go ahead and finish that building. I really don't understand why. Why didn't it finish? Because the other guy attacked him? Is that, does it stop the building? If you get attacked, is that what happened? I don't know, I don't get it, but hopefully we'll finish it next turn. I guess we'll see. Just finished this one. So we're just going to be hanging out for a few turns here. Who needs to tech up fastest? That's the question. I think they both have the guy, the doe. Right. Yes, they both have does. Put the poison on this guy. Helm of Discord. Okay, the other guy got Helm of Discord. That's fine. Potion of Foolhardiness. I need to be on the Gore Beast guy. Increase that charge bonus. And finally, do we want to combine units to save any cash or not? Let me see. I mean, we could. We'll have to buy him back as soon as this is done, so we have to keep that in mind after 8 turns or so. And combine a couple. Save some pennies here and there. I cannot combine anything here. And I think I've already purchased units here, so we're good on that. This is good. That's good. Let's look at... make sure we're good here. I think we're good here. The vampires seem to be doing very well. So he's gonna go hide in Artois, that's fine. Night of feasting or worship, you beasts. Alright, do we want leadership or do we want chaos? Hurts down. I mean, chaos is important. Sort of. I mean, like I said, I'm not exactly sure what kind of benefits I'm getting out of this. I know I don't take attrition. I'm in non-chaos territory. Leadership plus 10 for 5 turns. Could be really good if I run into another army as I move north. I mean, 5 turns is quite a long time. Yeah, sure. I really don't care about corruption that much, I don't think. I mean, it's obviously really good, but... whatever. Not gonna be a huge deal. I don't think. Just gonna take this place by myself. Blackstone. It's just 6 units. Put 6 on basically 7, but I have minotaurs. These should be able to hold the line, and the minotaurs should be able to get to their back line and kill those archers. And the spearmen should be able to take out the horsemen. I think we can do it. Let's do it. I just can't let them snipe my ward. This could be fool's gold, but... I'm gonna do it. Get another good fight in here. Really? It's thinking they can beat me. I mean, yeah, this lord basically isn't there, but... I mean, his minotaurs are. And these are really strong spears. Well, pretty strong spears. I mean, 37 attack. Pretty good. I'm gonna do it. plus 4 leadership. I'm going to put that on the Minotaurs. Just make sure they hold. So I just have to basically hide this guy so he doesn't die. If he does die, I can just replace him with Malagor, probably, which wouldn't be the end of the world. Maybe I should replace it with Malagor anyways. It's debatable. It's definitely debatable. But let's go ahead and fight the battle. He can, like, charge into archers or something, maybe, but, you know, I would really like for him not to fight. That'd be great. Alright, so I just want to get as high on this hill as I possibly can. They're going to try to take this area so that I won't get any kind of high ground advantage on, which is pretty smart, but it's going to be hard to do. It feels like I'm going to get some kind of high ground on, probably. I feel like the attacking army gets high ground advantage more often than the defending army quite a lot, which is pretty cool because I'm usually the attacking army in my campaign, so. I'll slow it down a little bit. Backside over here, get these guys out. Showered with arrows. I need to shoot these spears, I think, in the back. And these guys are pretty much neutralized. I'm gonna go ahead and charge them in the back. These spears are just gonna kind of be sacrificial, just charge into them. Did it. Oh geez, here comes some. Why are we not running north? What need to be doing? Get over here. They're done. Yeah, I don't know why I was giving them odds. I mean, I have Minotaurs. Like, Minotaurs are pretty... Rumor has it they're a good unit. Eye on my lord. I need to keep him up here with the rest of my units. Just make sure they don't, like, nothing crazy rallies and just runs up and snipes him. How many of these things killed? About 56. Pretty good. Everything else has killed small amounts. Well, these have done okay. Get them, lads. Yeah, they seem to have some area of effect attack. Minotaurs, it makes a little circle and, like, hits the ground when they attack. I like how they just, like, headbutt roll that. Minotaur's pretty big. God. Yeah, I'd be pretty scared to go fight those things. Alright, I think that's about it. Speed it up one more time. I think, yeah, that's it. That's good enough. It is just the garrison, but I want every penny. Every penny. And a little piece of experience I can get. So the archers killed the most stuff. Whatever. It's all replaceable. Ooh, steel claws. This is good. Nice. Money. I cannot recruit. Would like to get to 17 units, but I think I'm just going to combine these for now. Save that money. Now, Ziflin's going to be a bit harder to take, I think. Yeah, I'm going to need at least a couple more units. Alright, oh, we can hit Leonis this turn, wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 on 31, half are injured. So call it 18. 31 on 18, 17, something like that. Or no, 8 on 17 or 31 is what I mean. I have like triple the units I have. I'm just gonna auto resolve it. We run over there. Alright, so I can hire Shaman now. Well, I don't like these. Definitely not that one. Sneaky. I guess this one. Okay, well, I'm not gonna be doing a lot of assassin stuff with him, so this may not even matter. So that should not have cost me any movement. It did not, so I can still hit Leonice this turn.
By the Grail, never.
I don't care for this order.
Let's see what's going on with Frey Herd, what they have. Someone needs to wear that weapon of giant strength. It's a devolve, I can get that pretty quickly. I think that's where the money is. Oh, he can get a razor or chariot. Okay, sweet. That'll actually be really, really good. That'll make him quite effective in combat because of that large charge bonus. So his base amount's not gonna be very high, but that charge, it looks like it gives him a ton of armor too. Or at least way more than he has right now, so I think that's good. Yeah, so we're just gonna go Vile Tide. I mean, can I, what does the bigger one do? Increased armor. So 600 range, it's pretty good. I don't think it's going to be that great of a spell, but I can get that, and then, oh wow, whenever I cast a spell, allies get plus 24% speed and plus 10% vigor. That's pretty good. We definitely want to get Devolve. So we're going to get Surge, two Devolves, and one other thing. Maybe this, just for some more direct damage, I'm not really sure. That could be useful. Wow, that's good. That'll help with that Gore Chariot when I get that. What do I have down here? Bad. Decent. Wow, really? What? Minus 30% to all spells. I wonder if that stacks. I mean, would that be 80% cooldown? Jeez. That seems very, very overpowered, potentially, if that's what it is. I mean, you do still have a very limited supply of magic, but if they buff the spells and sort of tried to balance that out by giving them longer cooldowns, that palpable miasma right there will be a beast. Now this is nice. Oh, that causes damage to combatants. I forgot about that. That's pretty good. Good, good. Pretty standard, good. This just seems crazy. And for the Lord? Now, I wonder if spells include, like, activatable items. I doubt it. What hardy is that? Oh, do I have to choose? They did this kind of with the Gore Bowl, where you had to kind of choose a way that you wanted to go. Because it looks like these two aren't connected. Yeah, so maybe you have to just choose this or this. What's Proponent do? Construction. That's pretty nice. This does magic drop chance. Yeah, I don't think those are that great, but so we're probably going to just go magic here, and then we're going to get to palpable miasma pretty soon. Yeah, because that looks crazy. So we might just rush devolve 2 points and devolve into palpable miasma, and then just go from there. Okay, I like it. Now, how are we looking on time here? We are just about out of time, so let's go take Leonice, and then that'll probably be the end of the episode. Okay, so we have to attack with him. Is the Gore Beast able to knock down the door? He is not officially able to knock down the door. So we have to have Minotaurs for that. That's okay, we've got Minotaurs. Let's just go like halfway here just to make sure we're not walking anything crazy this time. Like I said, I doubt they have an army. We've already killed two of their big armies. I don't think they're going to have a third one showing up over here. Not this early in the game. I guess it is kind of like mid-game-ish right now, but... yeah, we're just going to auto-resolve it. It's, you know, whatever this is. 14, 28, 30... one, and even half of that would be 16, which would be double what they have. I have Minotaurs, I have Lords, you know, their knights are not going to be that great against all these spearmen, nor are they going to be great in the close quarters of a city, so, yeah, I'm just going to auto-resolve it. Hopefully you guys don't think that's abusive. If you do, I apologize, just let me know in the comments, but I think that's a fine auto-resolve. So I'm devoting two armies to go do it. I mean, it'd be different if, like, I just... you know, had all spearmen and just used one army to do it, but I'm using two. So I think that's pretty fair. That's about what I think I would have lost anyways. Okay, it's time for Moment of Truth. How juicy? Very juicy. You can taste it. It's delightful. Yes. Give me all that money. Alright, we just hit the jackpot. Now we're rich. we could build some stuff now. So we could go to tier 4. What is that going to give us with this army? Not going to give us much. I mean, we could get... it's going to take 5, 9 growth. We could rush straight to Sigors. It's only one more, so we could do 9, 10 growth and get Sigors, or we could do 9 growth and get Bestigor hurt. I just don't know if these guys are really necessary. You don't get discounts on them. Like, this gives you 10% for Ungor, but it doesn't give you any for Gorehurt. I mean, it's really all about the cost a lot of times, because these are only marginally more efficient than these. Like, these already cost way more gold. And they don't have the upgrades. Like, this is crazy. I mean, it has a melee attack of 49 right now. And it costs 60 gold upkeep. So, you know, yeah, it doesn't have a lot of armor piercing. I don't know. And the more I think about this Bestigor herd, the more I think that it's just not as good with the Beastmen. Like, it's basically almost the exact same thing as Black Orcs are. But... Orcs don't have a great alternative to Black Orcs. Like, I mean, I guess Trolls... I won't talk too much about the Greenskin campaign, but I feel like Black Orcs are better for their cost for several reasons. There aren't as many good alternatives to them, whereas these guys are just great alternatives. I mean, they're still really, really good. They're so cost-efficient for what they do. It just frees up money to get things like Minotaurs or... Sigors or other cool units. So I could go ahead and grow this. That would give me a little bit more growth. And eventually I could go to tier 5 with this guy and just get those Sigors going. I mean, that's so cheap for what they are. They're so good. We could get a giant or two also. I mean, the giants have a huge melee attack. These guys are a little bit lacking in the attack. 28 charge. What's the giant got on charge? 50 charge? Jeez. How fast? Not very fast, but... I don't think there's any techs that improve giants. Let me see. Or, like, large beasts. There is that one that's monstrous beasts, and I'm kind of curious to see if that will help giants. I look at this all the time. I don't think there's anything here that's gonna be a huge deal. I mean, this is good. Centigor. Vestigor. I mean, I could get faster research rates, but why? I mean, I don't know. I already almost have all the good techs. I mean, these are sort of good, yes, but it just takes so much time. I would like the replenishment, but I often find myself using that moon where it takes away all of your replenishment because I want the growth. And then just buy fresh units when you need them. Yeah. Alright. So, do I want to upgrade that already, or do I just wait? I mean, the faster that I get it, I might as well get it while I'm sitting here, not doing anything else. It does give you more growth every turn. Oh, I forgot. I can only recruit one. Okay. Making sure I couldn't recruit two. I can get two gore bulls, I think, when I get the gore bull thing. I'm not 100% with that. But okay, let's go ahead and build that. Sorry, spacing out there. Okay, let's go ahead and build that. And then we'll make him our monster builder. So we can get... I guess it makes sense to get the Cygors first. I mean, the Cygors are probably better than the Giants. That'll help tremendously with sieging. And it's only one more growth to pick them up. So it's pretty good there. Now I don't have to really get a chariot. Like, I was thinking about getting the pigs to get a chariot because that looks really good. But if the lords will have chariots anyways, then that already we already get that tactical function without having to invest in this. Alright. Get that. We cannot build minotaurs or anything. Now, I don't know the geography here. I'm not 100% sure where else. I think there's a town like here. This is the capital, I think. It's somewhere around here. We'll see. I mean, I could also double back and like pick up all of this stuff and just start moving into Empire territory. I think I would like to take out Artois first. That's going to be really hard to do. I might have to bypass Artois and move over here. I don't really know. Alright, let's see what are our options here to build. We can't build here, but we've only got one pop. We're gaining a lot less growth because we have this. This is our fighter army. And so I guess the path here would just be upgrade this and then get this. Although you only get Gorbals for that. Gorbals are very strong. Okay, cannot move him this turn. He's already moved, can't move him. Okay, it's going to be the end of this turn and probably the end of the episode. Could take Ziflin. Which one's easier? Is that 8? How much mana for it? Mana for it. Actually, it has more, although it does. Does it have high walls? It doesn't have high walls, but it's still more. And maybe I should just send the Vestigor up here and then just go over there and just fight this with, like, just 3, like, full stacks of units. And while I'm at it, I might as well hire. I think I have enough archers. And once I finish this tech, this will probably be worth it just to get the Ungor experience when I hire. But I want Encircled Prey first. Okay, yeah, let's just get these stacks all the way up and just hit them with like 60 units. Yeah, I think I just want to collapse and just make sure we get Artois. So let's rejigger our things over here. I really don't want them to siege it, though, without me being in the area. We'll see. Okay, it's going to be the end. Let's do this. What was that? How did I get vision of that? Here's Empire. Oh, my group just straight burrowed over there. Using the beast paths. I didn't expect them to go that fast. Oh, they're running. They're just gonna give me Artois. Oh, nice. So I get $1 zillion. Okay, there's one objective that I missed. I'm not sure what it is. It's whatever. We got 4 or 5. It's pretty good. Burn 8 things. Raise 14 places. Get 6,000 favor. Okay, that'll wait till next episode. So yeah, he's just straight abandoning ship. He's like, I'm out of here. Do they not have any recruitment there? Some men-at-arms, mounted yeomen, archers, grail knights. I don't know what those are. I really wish they'd just make Bretonnia like a full faction. Like, they've already got it, you know? Just let's do it. Like, you know, I understand procrastinating and how that works, but it's like, come on. Like, it's easy. Just $5 DLC, Bretonnians, boom. I would pay $5. I mean, I know it's already basically done. I don't even know what they have to add. Just add, like, one or two things. It's probably fine. Not a huge deal. I mean, they already have the Lord. They have a pretty good unit diversity. I mean, not as rich as some other factions, but whatever. I mean, you've got your spears, you got your halberds, you got a few different kind of horses, you got your flying pegasi, you got a couple of wizards. Got trebuchet. I don't know. It just feels like there's not that much more they need to be doing to get that ready. And so I do not want this. I do not want them to siege this. It may have changed, but I think it's really bad if they siege it because then you can't get them off of it. And I don't want him to get the money. We'll do that next episode, though. So thank you very much. We got a couple of good fights in this episode. Hope you enjoyed that. If you did, check out the rest of the campaign. We also now have other campaigns, like I said at the beginning of the video. Check those out. If you watch a few different videos and you enjoy it, consider commenting, you know, watching more videos, telling your friends about it, subscribing. Anything you can do to interact with the videos just really helps out a ton, and I greatly appreciate it. We're starting to gain some momentum, I think, with subscribers, so hopefully we can keep that momentum going. Thanks to you and, you know, all of your efforts watching the videos and subscribing and leaving those lovely comments. I really appreciate everything that you guys and gals do for me here. So that's going to be it for this episode. So thank you very much. It's always a pleasure broadcasting for you, and have a wonderful evening.